Microbes in sewage treatment. Sewage water. Sewage water is municipal wastewater. Large amount of municipal wastewater are generated every day. They are rich of human excreta as well as rich of organic matter and also pathogens, pathogenic bacteria and fungi. The sewage means municipal waste water, considered as sewage. It contains large amount of organic matter, microbes too, and pathogenic to human being. Do you know where the sewage water disposed of? Where the sewage water disposed of? The sewage water disposed into natural water bodies, rivers, streams, etc. Okay, directly. So, is there any damage to the water? Yes, there is a damage and making more pollutant the water bodies. Direct disposal of the sewage into the water bodies, that leads to the pollution, as well as it also causes the water, it also causes the many diseases for human being as well as living organisms. So, it make more pollutant the water bodies. So, to avoid that, there is a treating of sewage water before disposal of into the water bodies. For that, here the sewage water plants are established to reduce its sewage concentration. For this treatment, the treatment of wastewater includes, it is treated with heterotrophic microbes, and also the treatment is carried out into two ways. One is primary treatment, another one is secondary treatment. Primary treatment includes here the waste material, the solid material physically removed, physical removal of particles. How means here the filtration is the best procedure for the physical removal. So, sequential filtration followed to removing of solid particles which are present in the sewage. So, here primary treatment, first they receive the water into the large tanks, there they go for the filtration by using of different size of filters. Okay. So, sequential filtration resulted to the solid material is separated from the sewage water. Then go for the sedimentation. So, the sedimentation allows to the settlement of or sediment of the soil particles, sand particles, so they are settled at the water. And here after primary treatment, the primary sludge is produced and it is also called as effluent. The effluent from the primary settled tank is entered into the secondary treatment. So, the first treatment is physical manner. But second treatment is completely depends on biological activity of microorganisms. Here the biological treatment is followed. How the biological treatment is followed means, so the sewage is digested with the heterotrophic microbes. In the sewage already different types of the microbes are present. So, when they get aeration and vigorous agitation, the flocks are formed. Water flocks, the bacteria with the filamentous fungi, they are extensively grown and form as a net like forms. They are called as a flocks. The flocks are formed in the secondary treatment tanks. So, the flocks are very rich. It means they are consuming the organic matter. So, while they are consuming the organic matter, the absorption of oxygen also more. So, it means there is a demand of oxygen. So, such case we said as biochemical oxygen demand. When the biochemical oxygen demand is increasing, means there is a oxidation of organic matter is going on. Organic matter is oxidizing, means they are forming into complex to simple form. So, the purity of or purity check of the sewage is determined by using of the BOD. BOD is nothing but of biochemical oxygen demand. Okay. So, biochemical oxygen demand gives the result of the purity of the sewage. If the oxygen demand is less for the microorganisms, means the organic matter is oxidized. And then once the BOD of sewage is reduced significantly, the effluent is then passed into the settled tanks. There, the bacterial flocks are separated or go for the sedimentation. So, the sedimented bacterial flocks are called activated sludge. Activated sludge. So, this activated sludge, part of the activated sludge is used again for the secondary treatment. And most of the activated sludge go for the aerobic sludge digesters. There, the digestion of microbes has been carried out. And also, the biogases are produced during the digestion of microbes. And then there CO2 and methane gas as well as hydrogen sulfide are released in the form of biogases. It means this treatment is completed, means so the water is, the effluent is ready to release in the water bodies. It means the organic matter, the pathogenics are very less in concentration. So, that clearly says that the secondary treatment treat and kills the bacteria, microorganisms which are present in the sewage water, and also secondary treatments promotes the water releasing into the water bodies, sewage releasing into the water bodies. But anyway, growing population, increasing urbanization, sewage also being produced in much larger quantities than even before. So, the number of sewage treatment plants has not increased enough to treat such large quantities. So, the untreated sewage is discharged directly into rivers, leading to their pollution as well as waterborne diseases. That is why we have to improve the number of sewage treatment plants. We wanted to establish the sewage treatment plants. So, and the Ministry of Environment and Forest has initiated the Ganga Plan Action, sorry, the Ganga Action Plan, the Yamuna Action Plans to reduce the pollution of rivers. Under these plans, they proposed to build the large number of sewage unit to treat the sewage water. The water which is coming from the discharging, which is coming from the industries around the river. So, they are polluting the, they are releasing the pollutants into the, directly into the Yamuna as well as Ganga rivers. To purify that, the large number of sewage treatment units are established in the plan of Yamuna and Ganga action plan. As well as Delovibrio bacteria oris, the bacteria is using for cleaning or purification of Ganges water. Okay. Beside that, toxic substances are produced by microorganisms suddenly into the environment, especially in the form of air and chemical spills, lands, they contaminate the toxic waste. Means this process is called bioremediation. So, bioremediation is means microbes can be used to remove toxic substances that are accidentally released into the environment, such as oil or chemical spills, they contaminate the land and also water. So, through this bioremediation process, microbes are useful to remove the toxic substances. So, best example of bacteria, that is Pseudomonas putida, used for the bio remediation. Next, I am coming to the microbes in biogas production. So, in our India, in our villages, the biogas production plants are established by the two institutions, collaborative work of two institutions, research institutions. One is Indian Agriculture Research Institute, another one is Khadi and Village Industries Commission. So these two research institutes collaboratively work for establishment of biogas plants in India villages, So what is biogas? Biogas is mixture of gases. The predominantly the methane is present, along with that H2 as well as CO2 is present. But methane is used for cooking gas, and here the biogas production is by using of cow dung. So the cow dung is rich of the bacteria which able to produce the methane gas, that is methanococcus. Methanococcus bacteria are present in the gut of the digestive system of the animals, the rumen of the animals. The Methanococcus bacteria involved in the cellulose digestive process, and also it involved in the releasing of the methane gas. So that's why the cow dung is used in the production of biogas. Okay, so the biogas, the cow dung is called as a gober. From that gober we are getting the gas, that is called gober gas. Okay, so not only in sewage treatment but also in the biogas production also, the microbes are used using specially Methanococcus bacteria.